So this is an organic watermelon production study where we're using three different cover crops planted at four different intervals to reduce weed pressure, attract beneficial insects, and to improve soil health by adding organic matter and nutrients. The thing that makes any kind of vegetable production challenging is the fact that this is an organic management study. We don't have a lot of the same tools that conventional farmers have, so we have to be inventive. One of the things that we're trying to do here is, I'm a big believer in picking your own weed. Something is going to grow in there. Nature abhors a vacuum and they will fill it full of weeds. I came up with an idea of using cover crops so that we don't have any bare ground. Initial study is to see what is the prime time to plant your cover crops in relation to planting your watermelon. You can see there's four flags in this row here and one flag over there, and that signifies that that planting was planted 1 week before we put in the watermelon crop. Two flags signifies that we planted the cover crop at the same time as the watermelon. Three flags signifies that we planted the cover crop 1 week after the watermelon. And then four flags signifies 2 weeks after the watermelon. Once again, we have fewer tools than the conventional farmers, so we have to till more often. But one of the things that I found right off is when we did the first cover crop, there was a faint hint of green in the field when I got back out here. I planted anyway. That was a bad move. I should have waited till the ground dried again and tilled. You can't even tell, unless you look at the color of flags, which cover crop is supposed to be in there. As far as which cover crop is performing the best, as you can see, the buckwheat is doing super. And it's one of the best pollinator crops that you can use in a cover crop situation. The cowpeas, they don't really flower until later, so we probably won't get any benefit from attracting pollinators, but we do get the benefit of being a legume and getting nitrogen. We do have a clover that we picked, a subterranean clover, but the germination has been so poor, it's pretty much the equivalent of the control crop. My job is to come and take data on a weekly basis just to see what the changes are. What insects we're bringing in, both beneficials, pollinators, predators, and then plant eaters. So this is just the preliminary data from the first series of a 3-year grant. Initially, we've taken the fruit count and the biomass data. So far on the fruit count, although we haven't statistically analyzed our data yet, it is promising because on treatment 4, we got a watermelon count of 91. Treatment 3, we got 97 watermelons. Now, compare that to treatment 2, we got only 70. Now, treatment 1, we had 74 watermelons total. So, treatment 3 and treatment 4 outperformed significantly treatment 1 and treatment 2.